Ready for some networking theory? I know, try to control your excitement on this. I know it's difficult, but really, seriously, if you want a job or a career in the field of computer networking, you're going to have to know all about the OSI model. OSI stands for Open Systems Interconnection. The Open Systems Interconnection model is a structured model developed for computer networking in the 1970s, and it was developed by the International Organization for Standardization, or the ISO. And I know this can get confusing because the OSI was developed by the ISO, but I digress. It was basically developed as a way, it was developed and adopted, really, as a way of standardizing network technologies. The first and most important thing this model did was it allowed computers from different manufacturers to communicate with each other because it modeled networking hardware, software, and protocols. And it modeled them in such a way that they could communicate with each other. Manufacturers had a model to work under, which allowed them all to kind of leverage off of each other by being compatible with each other's devices. They had kind of a standardized model to work with. The OSI model is divided into seven layers or groupings of standardization that makes up kind of a hierarchy of sorts. I'm going to cover these seven layers here in this video lesson of this level one networking course. But if you want to delve deeper into the OSI model and the TCP/IP model, which I haven't even talked about yet, and how they are similar and different, as well as more thorough detail on what each layer does, you'll want to check out the level two course on this same chapter lesson. There are also other study materials out there that kind of go into more deeper detail about the OSI model. Also, keep in mind, just as a side note, that most of what is done in each of these layers is actually done on the actual networking card, the NIC of a computer. Not all of it, but for all intents and purposes, we can say that at this level of understanding networking. So what are the seven layers? The top layer is the application layer. Now, this is the layer where users communicate and interact with the computer and applications, as well as where the applications interact with all the other layers of the OSI model over a network. The presentation layer is the next layer down. This layer presents data coming from the other layers to the application layer. Now, it also translates data as needed from the application layer down to the session layer below it. And obviously, the next layer is the session layer. This is the layer that is responsible for each networking session between this computer and the other devices on a network. This is also the layer, the session layer is also the layer where presentation layer data is set up, managed, and dismantled. Then you have the transport layer. This layer, the transport layer, takes data from the upper layers, the session, the presentation, the application layers. It takes data from those and it combines it into a data stream for end-to-end transport between devices. So the transport layer kind of makes sure that it is transported from this device to the other and from the other device to this device correctly. It also takes data received from other devices and it delivers it up to the session layer to go back up the hierarchy if it needs to. That's data that it receives from the network. Then you get into the network layer. Now, this is also known as layer three. So when we talk about layer three in networking, we're talking about the network layer. This network layer is the layer where device addressing, see IP addresses, as a side note, where network addressing and data packet tracking actually takes place. This is where routers tend to do their magic at the network layer. Anything dealing with IP addresses and network addresses, this is the network layer that's involved. Next, you have layer two, which is the data link layer. Now, this data link layer is responsible for transmitting the data from the upper layers out onto the physical layer and the network. It also receives data from other devices on the network from that physical layer below it and takes it up into the upper layers of the OSI model. You also see at the data link layer, you also see flow control and error notification. Those things are done at this data link layer, this layer two. Last but not least, you have the physical layer. Now, the physical layer is the actual physical media or medium used to transmit and receive data in bits, either zeros or ones. Now, this is essentially the physical hardware, the NIC interface, the cables, the antenna, any physical hardware that makes up the network is basically in the realm of the physical layer. So that's the seven layers of the OSI model. And again, it's just a structured, standardized model that manufacturers of all of these different devices and contraptions on a network can kind of stick to make sure that they are on the same page, so to speak, with all of the other manufacturers of all of the other devices out there for networking so that they can all be used together on the same network or networks.